Hi, this is Haramrit Singh Sandhu, and I am going to discuss Hardy Cross method. So the objective of this lecture will be to estimate flow discharges for the given network by Hardy Cross method. So while introducing the method, I must say that this is an iterative method. Here input and outputs are known, but the flow inside is unknown. Nowadays, number of computer-based methods also being used to estimate flow discharges in the pipe network. When we are using Hardy Cross method, there are a number of steps, so we are going to discuss this. The first step is to identify loops. Then we have to assume flow distribution such that it satisfies the continuity equation. Then we have to compute the head loss for each pipe. The formula for this is this is RQ square. Then we have to compute the net head loss. If net head loss is not equal to zero, then we have to apply correction. So the formula for this is this, that RQ square divided by 2RQ and whole is minus. So then we have to apply corrections, and we have to keep on repeating, or we have to do the iterations till del Q becomes negligible. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss this pipe network. So here you can see that this pipe network is given, that A, B, D and C. Here input is given as 100 meter cube per second at junction A. For junction B, this is output is 20 meter cube per second. Similarly at junction D, output is 50 meter cube per second, and at junction C, this is 30 meter cube per second. R is also given, that R is the proportionality factor and depends upon the pipeline. So that first trial, here I am assuming that the flow discharge in the direction AB is 57. As we know, the principle of this method says that here inputs are known but not the inner flows we don't know. So what we have to do initially, we have to assume flow and the flow direction. So what we are doing in this pipeline, pipe network A, B, C, D, A, we are dividing this pipe network into two loops, that is A, B, C and B, D, C. So we have assumed that this flow is in the direction of AB, that is in the pipeline AB is 57. So the remaining flow is 43 will go in the AC. Why? Because 100 meter cube per second is coming in this junction A. If pipeline AB has 57 flow, then AC has the remaining, that is 100 minus 57, which is 43. So if we consider AB as 57 at junction B, 20 is going out, so remaining is 37. So now here again I am assuming that in the pipeline BD, flow is 20 meter cube per second, so remaining is 17. So after junction B, BD is 20 meter cube per second and BC is 17 meter cube per second. So we can see that in junction C, 43 units are coming from pipeline AC and 17 is coming from line BC. So total will be 60, and 30 meter cube is given, that this is the output. So we know that this 30 remaining is going toward CD. So I know that at junction D, 30 is coming from pipeline CD, and from BD is again 20. So total will be 50. So we can see that this is 50 meter cube per second is going out. So yes, this is the most important formula for calculation of Hardy Cross method. So this you have to remember. As we know that this pipe network we are dividing into two parts, that is A, B, C and B, D, C. So for each pipe network, or for each pipeline, that is loop A, B, C, we have to calculate these values. So what we will do, we will make a table of different pipes, that is AB, BC, CA, and we have to estimate the value of RQ square and 2RQ. Now we can see that AB is positive. Why AB is positive? Since AB is in the flow direction of the pipeline is clockwise direction. So here I am assuming that if flow direction is clockwise, then it is positive, and but if flow direction is anti-clockwise, then this is negative. That's why we are getting AB as positive, BC as positive, but CA as minus. Why CA as minus? Because this flow direction is in anti-clockwise direction. So for each pipeline, we will calculate RQ square and 2RQ. Now, using this formula, I will calculate del Q of this loop. The higher value is coming as 1. For loop PDC, again, we have to calculate these values RQ square and 2RQ. So we can see that BT is positive because flow direction is positive, but for the pipeline DC and CB, flow directions are negative. Why? Because this is in the anti-clockwise direction. So for similarly, we will get the values of del Q BDC. So here I got value as -3, and here del Q ABC is 1. We know that we have to do the iteration till we will get value of del Q as negligible. Since these values are not negligible, so I will go for the second trial. So how we will assume values for the second trial is depends upon the results of the first trial. That is, if we get the values of del Q ABC loop is 1, del Q BC is -3, we will assume that flow in the pipeline AB is 57 plus 1. Why? Because del Q ABC is 1 and for BD is 20 minus 3, that is 17. So we get new values depending upon the values of the first trial. So corresponding to 58 and 17, we will find out other values, and again we have to calculate del Q ABC and del Q BDC, that is for each loop, again using that same formula, that is for pipe RQ square 2RQ AB. For each pipe I have to calculate these values, I have to find out del Q value. Similarly for loop BDC also I will calculate the same value. So here I came to know that our del Q ABC is -0.18 and del Q BDC is -0.3. So we can say that these are negligible values, so we will stop our iteration here. So remember, you have to do till we get del Q value as negligible. Since during second trial these values are negligible, so we will stop our iteration and we will say that these are the results. So the here answer will be the discharge in the given network are as AB is 58 meter cube per second, AC as 42 meter cube per second, BC as 21 meter cube per second, BD as 17 meter cube per second, and CD as 33 meter cube per second. So thanks. Don't forget to like and share. Please like and share. So thanks. This is Dr. Harmanjit Sandhu. I am assistant professor in Department of Civil Engineering, Punjab Engineering College, Chandigarh, India. Thank you.